I'm gonna talk about cheap harpies, and trust me, I've dated a few. And every time, I've ended up with egg on my face. Well,
more of an egg-shaped rash. The Greeks had a thing about monster women. The Lamia, the Gorgons, the Sirens, the Furies, the Harpies.
So remember, children, if it has a vagina, it could be a monster. Which is why we ancient Greeks have sex with teenage boys. Alright, story time's over. Time for sex with teenage boys. Chop chop.
Zeus gave Phineas the gift of prophecy, and when he shared his knowledge of the gods' secrets with his people, Zeus punished him for it. Yeah, I guess that's what gods did. They gave people superpowers, and when they used them, they got pissy about it. Anyway, Zeus blinded him and placed him on an island with a buffet of food, and it was Golden Corral, and it gave him diarrhea for all eternity. No, I'm just kidding. It wasn't Golden Corral. It was a good buffet. But every time he reached to sate his hunger and grab a piece of food, the harpies would fly out of the sky and rip the food right from his hands. And when the harpies filled their bellies, they did their dirty birdie business all over the lamb kebabs.
And that's how Greek yogurt was invented.
The harpies continued to torment King Phineas until Jason and the Argonauts showed up and drove the monsters from the island. According to the ancient legends, harpies were supposed to embody the destructive power of wind. You know what? Harpies maintain their popularity throughout the medieval period. They even appear in Dante's Inferno, where they populate the Forest of Suicides. If that sounds familiar to you, Neil Gaiman would use this location in his Sandman series. Harpies are a real meat and potatoes D&D monster. They fit in almost any published setting, so it's only natural if you want to give your players a case of harpies. Oh, the stat block says they come in packs of 7 to 12, so let's just buy 8 pre-painted ones. Oh, that's about $20. So let's see what 8 Reaper Bones would cost, okay? That's also about $20. You know what? I'm gonna make 10 for $3.60. $3.60. We're gonna go to Miniatures Market, and we're gonna order Dinosaur. See, Dinosaur is one of the kooky Great Lakes Avengers.
And she's a big purple dinosaur. It's like Bonnie, remember? That joke's not dated.
This is a recent posting from Miniatures Market. They've got more than 20, which is where they cap off and stop counting. So they have a lot of these in stock, and they are only 35 cents each. Another reason I'm pointing you towards this particular miniature is because she can also stand in for a gargoyle, a succubus, a vampire, a phantom, a werebat, and just so many different generic sort of winged female monsters that this figure could be. And it's a pretty cool sculpt. I know, the pink paint makes it look ridiculous. We're gonna change it up, they're gonna look pretty cool when we're done. So like with all my Heroclix conversions, or at least 99% of them, I'm gonna start by taking them off the base. Now, if I were smart, I'd be holding the base with a nice pair of pliers and using a good pocket knife to just pry them off. But I host videos where men knock cans over with farts, so obviously that's not who you're dealing with here. I'm using a pair of wire snips, which turns out are kind of sharp on the end. Next, I'm going to dip them into acetone. Now, they are this clear plastic, which is why they're giving me a tougher time than usual. It's more rigid than the typical Heroclix plastic they use. But the upside is, it seems really resistant to acetone. You can pretty much just let these soak in there. Let them sit in there for a good amount of time, pull them out. They don't seem any worse for wear. They're not soft. And then you just take the paint right off with the brush. It just falls right off. So once I've done that, I'm going to prime them in black, no surprise there, and I'm gonna just give them a nice, quick, dirty, gray dry brushing. Inside the eyes, I'm gonna do a dot of orange, so it gives it a highlight, gives it kind of a glow. I'm also gonna do the feet in the yellow, sort of like a crow's feet, just to break it up a little bit. The gray just seemed a little lazy to make them a solid gray. I wanted to give them some other kind of detail just to make them more interesting, so I think the yellow feet worked out okay. Once we're done painting them, I'm going to flock the bases with green tea and just a white glue. With that pink paint off, they already look a lot spookier. I wouldn't feel them just on the black. I think you do need to do a little more than prime these. They're not that interesting in the solid black. You do wanna dry brush some gray on there. But they have a nice spooky look. They've got a nice, like I said, these could pass for gargoyles easily. You can use them as statues pretty easily. They're good and eerie. There's something eerie about them for sure. Yeah, we applied the glue nice and evenly to the base here, this Elmer's glue. It's a little thicker than I like, but that's fine. And we're going to dip this into the green paint nice and evenly. And then I usually blow off the excess, or I'll tap it on the side so it'll get green tea everywhere.
As always, you can visit us on Facebook. If you'd like to support the channel, please consider making a donation to my GoFundMe campaign. The links for both are in the description below. As always, thanks for watching.
She never cooks. She keeps a filthy house and she talks profanely. She's the queen of the harpies.
No, I'm not.
Queen of the harpies.
No, I'm not.
Here's your crown, your majesty.